Welcome back. This video will show you how to boost your microphone to make it louder within Windows 10. I have two main ways to boost your microphone, but we'll start with a few simple methods before moving on to the main ones. Firstly, check on the mic itself for a dial or similar that might change the mic sensitivity. Not all microphones will have this, but it is worth checking just in case. The next thing you might want to try is adjusting the mic level within the app that you are using. Not all software will allow for this though, but try looking in the audio settings to see if there's any option. This will most likely help if you find your mic to be too quiet in just a few apps. Also, it's worth mentioning that if you don't use your microphone live, then you could possibly use software like Audacity to boost the volume of it after recording. You may also need an external power supply depending on the mic you have for it to work properly, so search for your make and model of microphone to see if this is the case. Now moving on to the main fixes, the first method will be to boost the microphone within the sound control panel. To get to the sound control panel, first go to the main settings page, which can be accessed by clicking on the cog icon from within the start menu. In settings, click on system, and then sound. Now find where it says sound control panel. It should be in blue and on the right side of the window. In the sound control panel, go to the recording tab, which should be the second option. Find the microphone you want to boost from the list and double click on it. Now go to the levels tab. Hopefully in this tab you see at least two options. There should be a 0 to 100 slider and a boost slider. Increase the number of the top slider to increase the level of your microphone. If it's already at 100, then you can add a boost by increasing the second boost slider. If you only see the top slider and you don't have the option to boost, then unfortunately not all mics will support this. However, there are a few things we can try in order to get the boost slider. The first thing to try will be to go to the Advanced tab and then uncheck the two boxes within here. You can also try another port on your PC, update your drivers, and this can be done by going to Properties within the General tab, then the Driver tab, then Update Driver, and then the Automatic Search. You could also try the Microphone or Sound Recording Troubleshooter by searching for Troubleshoot in the search bar and running it. After trying each of these, check to see if you now have the boost option. If you do, then feel free to increase it, but if you don't, then we'll move on to the second main solution. The next solution will require you to install a piece of software called Equalizer APR. I've made videos recommending this software before to boost the volume of your headphones, but it can also be used to boost your mic too. You'll need to head to the website. The link to this will be in the description. By following the link, you should be on this page. If your operating system is 64-bit, and most of yours will be, then you can click this green download button here. If you have a 32-bit operating system, you will need to download the software from another place. This version can be found by going to the Downloads tab, and then you can choose the version with the 32 in its name. Start the download for the version you need and allow it to complete. Before we move on, if your download didn't start automatically, then click on the grey Problems Downloading button, and then click on the blue Direct Link button, and it should now begin downloading. If it still doesn't work, then you could try a different browser. Once downloaded, click on it in your browser to open it up. You should be prompted with the user account control screen, and you will need to choose yes on this. Now you should see the installation window. First click next, and then I agree. Now you'll need to choose a destination folder for the software. The default location should be fine, but just make sure you make note of where you save it, as we will need to find it later. Click Next when you are happy with the location, and now you should be able to choose if you want it in a Start Menu folder. You can choose Do Not Create Shortcuts by checking the box, and you're now ready to click Install. Once it has installed, it will prompt you with a new window. In here, we will need to first go to the Capture Devices tab, and then you should be able to choose your microphone from the list. If you don't see your microphone, check that it is connected properly. Check the box next to it and then click OK, and then OK again. You will now need to restart your PC for it to be able to boost your microphone. Feel free to do that now by choosing Reboot Now, or manually reboot later if you have Work open, but of course remember to save anything you are currently doing. Return to the video once you've restarted your PC and we will be able to continue with the setup. So now you should have restarted and the first thing we will need to do is go to the place that we saved the software. For me it was within the Program Files folder, which is found by going to This PC in the File Explorer and then Local Disk. The folder you need to click on is called Equalizer APR, and within it you need to open the application called Editor. You may get a message that says Equalizer APR has not been installed on the selected device, but don't worry, just click No. We now need to find where it says Device at the top, click on the drop-down box and select your microphone under where it says Capture Devices. You may also need to change the Channel Configuration drop-down box next to it to Stereo, for example. There should be three options to change on the page, but we only need to change the value in the preamplification section, which should be at the top. That means you can remove the two other options if you wish by selecting the red Remove button. If you don't see preamplification, then you can add it by clicking on the green plus icon and then choosing Basic Filters and then Preamp. Increase the gain slightly and then you can test your mic. The default should be -6 and I would recommend taking it up to around -3 at first, as the more you boost your mic, the lower the quality will be. Remember to click File and then Save to make sure your changes are implemented. If the software doesn't appear to make any changes to your mic level, then there are some things to try on the Equalizer APR download page and this link will also be in the description. There's also more help on how to install the software on there too, if you need it. Also, if you ever want to uninstall the software, then just head back to the Equalizer APR folder and run the application called Uninstall and follow the steps. And so that's how to boost your microphone level in Windows 10. I hope I was able to help you. If you have any questions or suggestions, then feel free to leave them in the comments. If the video helped, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe. Thanks for watching and I will see you in another video.